Hello! In this video, we're going to be showing you how to paint the RVR Cyber-mastiff quickly, so he'll be ready to do what he does best. Track prey and break bones for its Exaction Squad. The first thing we need to do is undercoat the model, and for this we've used Chaos Black. It's perfect for all the dark details for our base paints. Normally, we would advise you to have the base paint that matches this spray, but don't worry as we'll be using this base paint later in the video. The 10 paints you need are on the screen right now. Remember that these are our recommendations. Feel free to paint your miniatures however you like. If you are new to painting or want to know the paints and the techniques used in this video, check out our Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos in the description. First, we'll apply Rhinox Hide to the body of the Mastiff with our small base brush. We'll apply a few thin coats to get that solid brown base over the black. Just remember to get the underbelly and the top half of those front legs too. This might make a bit of a mess on the undercoat of some other areas. This is totally fine as we'll be covering those later with other colours. If you want lighter fur for the body, you can also pick any other brown colours you want. Next, we'll be using a lead belcher for the silver details, such as the mechanical legs, pipes, jaw, spine and tail. We'll be using a small layer brush as there's a lot of small details that require controlled brush strokes. Just like before, we want a couple of layers of this colour to build it up. Just be mindful of the fur that we just painted. If we do get a little bit of lead belcher on that fur, let it dry, then apply some more Rhinox Hide over the top of it. Lead belcher is great for the regimental silver found on many Imperial units, making it perfect for weaponry, servo-constructs and augmentations. Now we'll apply Rune Lord Brass to the chest eagle, mouth plates, back and tail transistors. These are small details, so we'll be using our small layer brush again for these. As they are so small, they will dry really quickly. This means if you need another layer of paint, to get that solid coverage, you won't have to wait too long. Now is the time to change our paint water, so we don't get any metallic flakes into the rest of our paints. Rune Lord is perfect for the dark, worn brass work for the Exaction Squad, but you could use Retributor Armour for a bright, clean gold for these noble yet humble servants of the Emperor. With our paint water now clean, we can apply Catechan Flesh for the leather straps and small pouches on the side of the Mastiff. As these details are very small, we'll stick with our small layer brush for these, so we can avoid getting this colour on already painted areas. We're using Catechan Flesh for these leather details so they stand out from the darker brown fur of the body, but you could swap these colours around if you want a darker leather and a lighter fur. Next, we'll use Carrick Stone on the two larger pouches. Still using our small layer brush, we'll be applying 2 to 3 thin layers as this is a lighter colour going over a black undercoat. Try to avoid the two bullets on one of these pouches. They are very small though, so don't worry if you do get paint on them. You can easily tidy this up with lead belcher after the pouches are dry. Carrick Stone might be a layer paint, but it's perfect for the rough, slightly dirty cream-coloured material. With that dry, we can apply Mephiston Red to the pipes, eyes and the icons on the larger pouches. We'll take our time painting this colour onto these details with our small layer brush, as we have done a lot of great work applying our previous colours. Just like before, we can easily tidy up by using these colours, so don't worry about making a mess. Mephiston Red is a bright base paint for all of these details, but we'll be shading it down later to add a bit of depth, tying them down to the rest of the dark colours. Now that the majority of our colours are on the model, we can look at painting the armour that covers the Mastiff. For this we'll be using Abaddon Black. Having a model undercoated in Chaos Black really helps us with painting this armour, as we'll only need one coat over some major areas like the shoulders and the chest plate. Remember to cover the underbelly and the ribcage plating too, just take your time when doing so. This can also help the armour match the rest of the model when it's dry, but also covers any accidental smudges of those colours too. Even though it is subtle, it's 100% worth doing this step to make sure everything is ready for our last colours. With all our base coats applied, we can move on to Rattling Grime and we'll thin it down slightly. We'll be using 1 part Rattling Grime to 2 parts water and applying it over the Lead Belcher and Catechan Flesh. Using our small base brush, we'll add small amounts of this paint over those details. As a lot of these details are really small, we'll make sure that we don't overload the brush and see how it sits on the model. If you see it start pooling heavily in some areas, just take a clean damp brush and soak it up before it dries. Rattling Grime is a contrast paint, but is super versatile for making a grimy, oily shade when thinned down slightly. Next, we'll use Agrax Earthshade over the Rune Lord Brass, Carrick Stone, Mephiston Red with our small base brush. For the brass and the red, we'll be using the shade straight out the pot. For the Carrick Stone pouches, we'll thin it down a little bit with some water. One part Agarex Earthshade to two parts water will be lighter, but still add some nice shadows. It's easier to add layers of lighter shades rather than try and fix a shade that is too dark. Wait till that first layer is dry before adding a second if you wish. Agarex Earthshade is perfect for making lighter colours on this model look grimy but not too dark. Finally, we can add an extra little detail by highlighting the black armour with Thunderhawk Blue. We'll be using a small layer brush as it's the best brush for these super fine details. A good way to make sure that we can keep our paint controlled on the model is keeping the brush tip pointed. This can also control how much paint we have on our model too. We'll use a combination of the side of the brush for those raised edges and the tip to get into those harder to reach places. We're using Thunderhawk Blue for this as it's a cold tone, which is perfect for highlighting black. But you could also use Dawnstone for a grey tone instead for your squad. The choice is yours. And there we are, your RVR Cyber-mastiff is finished. His bite is definitely worse than his bark. You can see that our model is based in Stirling mud, but you can base it in any colours you want. If you'd like to learn more about basing, check out our technical paints video all about it. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video and we'll see you next time. Bye bye!